Today we're going to be taking a look at 5 skulk sensor contraptions in 5 minutes. Also, shout out to one of my friends on my Discord server for making me this Christmas skin. It looks pretty awesome, and you should definitely go join the Discord server if you haven't already. Our very first contraption is just a simple auto lighting system. You walk inside here, and it turns on these redstone lamps up here. I'll show you how this works. Basically, all that it does is it just takes one signal from the skulk sensor. The skulk sensor's down here. We can actually go into spectator mode so you can see it better. Skulk sensor is right here, and it just sends a signal up here, and then it triggers this piston that's just like a copper clock kind of thing. And there's a ton of items that just count back and forth between the hoppers, and I take a signal off of this area here, and it just goes to the redstone lamps. So it's pretty simple, and it remains on for quite a few minutes before turning off, and then it will just like, it'll just activate again whenever you move again. Moving on now, we've got a simple automatic door system. Although, like, real automatic doors, you kind of have to, like, walk around a little bit in front of it to fully make it activate sometimes. So, if we have the same thing over here, we can make that activate. It's pretty simple. There's just, like, a little bit of redstone under here. I'll show you this again. If we look down here, we've just got 2 skulk sensors, and they both just connect to these pistons here. Next up, we have a slightly more complicated build. This is an automatic defense system, which is actually pretty cool, I think. So right now, I believe it's turned off. Yes, it is turned off. If we were to flick that lever, that would arm the defense system. So if you walk into here, you trigger the skulk sensor while it's armed. It's gonna dispense some TNT, drop the TNT down from there, and then it will blow you up. And it will continue doing that until you stop triggering this, basically, like, if you were to die. So this is a demonstration if we go into survival mode here. We just sit here next to the TNT. Not that, why did that not hurt me? Okay, apparently having to be on peaceful mode stops you taking damage from TNT, so now we just blew up. And it looks like even all the TNT is out of the dispenser. If we take a look over here, this thing has stopped actually trying to fire because there's obviously no entity there anymore because I blew up. And that would be the same for like a different player or a mob. No. But if we were to just leave the area, this thing is going to shut off here in a moment, I believe. That should be the last rotation, yep. And if you flick that lever, it activates one more time before just getting locked, and now it doesn't matter if the skulk sensor triggers, it'll still, like, just remain locked. It won't do anything. We should probably put more TNT in here, though. Our next contraption is a super simple armor equipping station that just uses a skulk sensor. So you run in here, you stand here, and it'll activate, and it gives you full diamond armor, a diamond sword, and a shield. And so I think it's pretty cool. It's a pretty neat little thing. You can also do similar things with pressure plates, but this is even a little bit more hidden. Basically, the skulk sensor, it can do a lot of things that things like pressure plates or buttons or tripwires would do, except that it can be completely hidden until it's activated. Like, you have no idea it's there until you activate it. That's why it also works extremely well for traps. Like in a video that I made, where I made a landmine using the skulk sensor, you should go check that out if you're interested. But it's completely hidden, no way you can detect it until it's already activated. I'm sure you noticed this giant wall of skulk sensors, observers, and redstone lamps over here, and this is actually the 5th contraption that I made. It's extremely big and it can be laggy, but I think it looks really cool. So if you throw snowballs or just trigger this in some other way, it creates these really cool patterns of redstone lamps. I think it just looks really cool. It doesn't, like, serve a specific purpose, but I just think it looks awesome. Like, that totally looks awesome. You could even expand it even more than this. Like, this is already huge, but you could make it even bigger, and it would probably look even cooler. And also, whenever you throw one snowball, it will actually activate twice because it's using observers. That was a really cool sound. So it sends a signal both times, when it's first activated, then when it returns to normal. So you can see that it does that. It also makes a really cool sound. That actually sounds so cool. It is a little bit laggy, but it does sound awesome. That's our 5 skulk sensor contraptions for today. If you like this video and you want to see a part 2, be sure to comment down below and hit that like button. And if you're new around here, consider subscribing. It's free. You can always unsubscribe. We're trying to get to 5,000 subscribers. That'd be very much appreciated. But that's going to be all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. I've been Speev, and I'll see you in the next video or live stream. Bye.